but for the time being, since today is an introduction class, so let me just go through this in interesting some of the interesting things that is on offer. So primarily this is 2020, so 2020 offers at this point of time, this is what we are ideally in a position with, where each individual is having more than multiple wireless devices which they are connected to. And even now we are doing process using the same techniques almost via digital platform that we are meeting together. So all this is the advent of wireless communication, which helped all of us in achieving some of the things which were purely impossible at some point of time. Who would have thought in maybe in early 2000 that a school or a college class can be conducted over an online, where around 70 odd people will register and will come and join the class together. No one has ever imagined it time maybe. So that is how the advent of or the usability of this scenario has occurred. The thing is, I will just show you just some important statistics that why we are dealing with this type of idea. One of the reason for going forward towards with this subject is that, as I told you, that this is a very much essential subject for if you wish to go ahead in master's and PhD with the same odd topic, then you require this as one of the prerequisite as WMC. So that is one of the reason why, from the academic point of view, it's very important. Also, in terms of the professional angle to it, there are companies which will be purely working on the telecommunication sectors, and like, for example, the Reliance Jio, the Vodafones, even Cisco at times, Siemens also works in the network domain, and other companies also, to name a few. And this site, these companies will, at least they used to come for placement even for VIT till last year. So hopefully for this year also they might come in at some point of time, and they will purely go on discussing this type of things, this topics in fact, will come in handy to get through this company. So that is one of the idea. But if I consider the market strategy and the process that is involved, so this is a TRAI document that gives us in 29th February, the latest of the TRAI document. So you can observe that this is all in millions, okay? This is all in millions that we are discussing over here. So this is in millions, okay? So you can observe that the wireless community is growing as fast as possible, okay? And you can observe that if you compare the wireless to wireline, the wireline is being the landline telephone number. You can just write in the chat box that how many of you are having a landline connection for that matter. Okay, so like I don't have a proper wireless landline connection, a wired landline connection, neither I think most of you will have any connection, but if you have any, you can just write it in the chat box for that matter. So you can see that mostly this is only for 1 month, and you can observe that total urban telephone subscriber, okay, in million is around 643 million in that way. And also you can see, in comparison to the wired connection, it is humongous, okay? So it's a huge revenue that will come in from this particular telephone. This is only for the urban. We have also the rural and the rural customers as well. So all this will go up. So this is basically where the people are investing money on a telecommunication or telecom sector for that matter. And that's why it's a very, very lucrative business opportunity for many. And that is one of the another aspect why this particular subject or the topic involved will go on evolving itself from one point to another. Because each and every time the user will, because all this is all based on the subscriber, see? And remember one thing, this user, whatever you are asking, user means we are asking for it, the network operator should be able to provide that facility to the end user. Because if you are not providing one, then I have the option and the luxury to switch from one network to another. That's where you will find that in so many ads and commercials, when it comes in from be it Airtel, be it a Reliance Jio, or any Vodafone or anything for that matter, every time each and every subscriber does count for all these operators. So that's why they are very, very careful in what to manage, how to manage. That's why they keep on giving you different set of offers so that you don't wish to change from one operator to another. Okay, so that is what I thought of just giving you the latest statistics. But another very interesting statistics that will come in handy, and that is you can observe that this is a particular slide again from a TRAI document, and in the graph, if you can observe that this is September 2016. This is September 2016. September 2016 to October 2016. Okay, there's a specific reason why I'm specifically mentioning this particular aspect of date. So September 2016 and October 2016, you can observe that there is a growth rate of around 2.67%, which in terms of million, if you consider, it's huge. Okay, it's a huge jump from one point to another. And also if you observe that total wireless subscriber, that also increased to around that percentage during this period, okay, between the September 2016, please make a note, to September 2016 to October. And if you check in that aspect, why I'm specifically focusing on this, if you just remember that this is the time at which Reliance Jio actually came to the market. Okay, it was formally launched on 5th of September, if I'm not wrong, 2016. Okay, so you can see that this September to October, okay, this 2016, this particular range of month gives us an indication that why there is a sudden increase in the population. And based on that, at that point of time, just see this carefully. Okay, this will give you some interesting statistics. So this is, again, you can see this is 31st October 2016. This is the data. Okay, I'll show you that now, the context of 2020 as well. And in this, you can observe that there is a very tiny small thing is placed as 3.3%. Okay, a small tiny little thing is present here as Reliance Jio. All right, so if this Reliance Jio, if you observe that this is a 3.3%, and this is the share, market share that it has, and compared to Bharti Airtel or Vodafone or Idea or BSNL, is a tiny portion of it. Okay, but this 3.3%, the inclusion in the market, actually had that many people in millions to get an increased number of population of subscribers for that particular operator. Just keep in mind this. Okay, just keep in mind this. And you can see this is a statistic with respect to Reliance Jio just in the month of October. So October means it's an addition, net addition of what happened during the September to October. Okay, so you can see Reliance Jio had this much of huge jump compared to any other operator at that point of time. Okay, and also you can see that the wireless subscriber, again in the same way, if you only consider the wireless subscriber, it will be definitely high. Just keep in mind this. I'll come back to this after some other slide. And also you can observe that during that period, Idea and Bharti Airtel, okay, these two had a substantial amount of number of subscribers which are VLR subscribers. Okay, now what is VLR subscriber? I'll tell you sometime later, but for the time being, we are not going to discuss that. I'll just want to finish off with this statistics for that matter. We'll come back after that. So this is also statistic in which shows that the visitor location register, this VLR stands for visitors location register. Okay, VLR, it stands for visitor location register. Okay, so you can see, so this is some kind of a database, you can see. And in that database, you can observe that Bharti Airtel was almost around sharing around 87%. Okay, almost around that part of the thing. And also you have the others also coming in. There's a reason for it. I'll come back after some slide. Now, coming to 2016, this is again the market share for wireline, which is not that important. And you can see that wireline, the BSNL, why they are going on to that scenario. that it has a decline. It's a negative growth that you are observing over here in that period. Okay, so the wireline connectivity is really in a, on a botheration because of this, the advent of wireless, so much of thing. Now, just check this thing out. Okay, now you can observe this is the statistics that I already had shown you on. This is for 31st October 2016. Okay. Now, this is where I told you that this is where the Reliance Jio actually came into market. And this is what we are looking at over here as the different statistics for urban telephone and rural telephone network. Now, if you observe over here in 31st March 2018, okay, so you can observe that the number of the total, the subscriber that is over here, that also has increased and it is increasing, but the increment is not humongous. It's little less, in fact. Because by this time, the saturation, some of the saturation for Reliance Jio has also come in some way. But you can observe something very interesting has happened. This is 2016 data that I showed you, the 3.3% of Reliance Jio over here. Now, this is 31st March 2018. Okay. And you can now observe that Reliance Jio over here is now sharing around 15.76% by 2018. So from 16 to 18 of around 2 years, it has gained a lot of popularity and it will share around 15% of the market share. The Vodafone as well as the Bharti Airtel remains almost the same. But what happened because of Reliance Jio, some of the smaller things are not present over here. You can observe that this proportion or maybe the quadrant over here, okay, quadrant over here. So those things are missing over here. Because those being procured by Reliance Jio, okay, in terms of the market share and all. Now, another interesting statistic is this. This is 29th February 2020, okay, right few months back. Now you can observe that what has happened over here, that at the current scenario, if we consider this from the TRAI document, and this is the latest one available, now Reliance Jio is offering around 32% of the market share, okay, compared to any other. Now, if you compare here, there is no Telenor, no Tata, okay, no Idea. You can see Telenor, Idea, Reliance, something was there, okay, some portions were there. All are missing over here because Reliance Jio is now one of the leading service provider because it has a much, much wider audience and a much bigger subscribers. And that's why they have procured all these smaller operators and they have made their own business in that way. Okay, so that is the net addition of Reliance Jio has made, and that's why you will now find that most of the advertisement that you will come across, it will be either Reliance Jio or Bharti Airtel, or at max sometime it will be Vodafone. It won't be anything else. No other things or other operators will cease to exist for the time being. So that is the power of wireless subscribers or the beta waves that you are following up with. Has the revenue is directly related to the revenue, because Reliance Jio is earning so much of revenue from all of us. I guess all of you must be having at least one or a Jio connection for that matter. Okay, so that is how the process is involved. Now, so this is the significance of how the addition, net addition of Reliance Jio changed the market scenario completely. So let me just show you another Indian context, which is this is a TRAI report again available in the internet as well. This is a document that was available in Times of India, in fact. So I thought of just sharing this with you so that you can understand. Although the data is 2000 till 2017, it's not updated after this. So it's basically the rates are coming down. Okay. So guys, can you see this slide a little bit? Because I'll be going on asking the questions related to this, in fact. Any doubt till this point? If you have any doubt, please make sure you can write it in the chat box. If you have any doubt, I can just check it once and again over here. Now, so you can see the trend, okay? Trend, you can see in the first graph here, in the first graph, the rates are coming down. So what does that mean? That in 2014, okay, the average data tariff per GB of data usage was much, much higher. It was around 269 rupees in that way, compared to now where it comes around 19 rupees. This is a like an average statistics from taken from different vendors together, and you can observe that this is one of the reason why the subscribers we are getting, the operators are getting so much of business. Because as we go along here, we can observe that in 2014, I don't know whether you people remember it or not, but at least I remember when we used to have the mobile data, okay, which was very, very expensive at times. We used to we will switch on the mobile data, we'll use for some time and then we'll switch it off. Because the more you use, the more tariff you will pay. It is same now as well, but the amount of data is, first of all, is more, and secondly, the cost of that is also pretty less. So that is why people are using more and more data. As you can see over here in the same graph, in the opposite way or the other way around, that in 2014 the data usage was around 0.26% in that way, data usage per month, which has shoot up to around 4 in 2017. And if you just extrapolate this data for 2019 and 20, it will eventually be more and more compared to this. Okay, so it will be definitely higher, and I don't think you need any explanation for this. We are actually going on using the device for many different purposes. For example, many of you might be online only using mobile phones, so you are using actually your data. And in terms of, if you suppose you are not using a Wi-Fi, then basically you are using your mobile data to get in touch with the particular class and all. So definitely it will be higher in that way. The other aspect to this is, this is very interesting. I really like this particular statistics. This is voice call after Jio offers. Okay. Now you can observe that in 2014, 15, 16, where again, as I told you, the timeline is very important. That before the advent of Reliance Jio and the free calls over for a period of time and unlimited calls and all, 14, 15, 16 was on an average, the voice minutes per user per month was almost the same. People were a bit reluctant in using calls. We used to, even if, I don't know whether you people remember it or not, we used to give missed call for that matter at times to make someone to call back. Okay, we used to send SMSs, but that for SMS we required a special pack to be installed or to be purchased. Otherwise, we won't be able to talk. Okay, but you can see that from 16 to 17, where more and more Jio users come into between, as well as Jio started offering the free data service, the 1 GB data initially, and then the 2 GB data now, and going on further with that. So you can see that the 2017 onward, the voice, now people are talking more because the expenses come down. Okay, and in a way, you can observe that here, cost of voice and data, that also has resulted into something coming down. You can see average revenue per user for voice and data, the left-hand side. Okay, so you can see 2014, 15, 16 was almost the same, but it started to decline in 17. Now, you might say, can anyone tell me that, where, then what is the benefit of having this particular model? In terms of the revenue, when we are looking at it, is we are losing out the revenue over here in 2017. Then why we are going forward with this particular model? Can anyone please suggest me?
The number of subscribers have increased, sir.
What is your name? I'll just keep a note of the names, because at times I might give you some credits because of these answers and all. So what is your name?
Yagnik.
Yeah, your registration number is
17VC0888.
888. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the answer is absolutely correct in that way. That the more we are actually using, the system in that way, the more revenue we are actually providing to the end user or the network operator in that way. So although it is showing that the average revenue has come down, the thing that it has not considered is the number of subscribers that multiplied humongously between this period. So that's why what will happen eventually, that the network operator will get a lot of people, subscribers coming into it and starting using it. So more and more they are using it, even if it is much smaller or less in the cost, the overall multiplication will give you a much bigger costing for that matter, or revenue for that matter. So that is primarily the business strategy, and we are not going to discuss further onto that part, to be honest. So let me just show you another thing. I think can I just ask you in that way, that have you heard the term of mobile portability, mobile number portability? Have you ever heard the term?
Yes, sir.
I think many of you might have heard that, and might have actually used the facilities to do it. But as an engineer, we should be knowing that how this process, or rather the communication engineer rather, we should be knowing that what is the physical principle that goes in between to go ahead with the MNP. Okay, so in that way, so MNP can be, it is not only that what we are talking about is that it is only a the number that is getting portable. So it can be a service provider portability, it can be a location portability, it can be a service the location I think service portability I have written multiple times. So one is service provider portability, and the other one is a service portability. So you can see the first one is what we mostly are relatable to. Please make a understand this, that this portability provides the flexibility of a mobile user to retain their mobile number when switching to one service to another, but in the same area. So this is what is defining it with respect to area, because if you remember, if for particular area, there will be, you have purchased your SIM card from a particular area. We'll discuss that when we discuss on the GSM and all, that when you are purchasing a SIM card from a particular area, you actually are you actually are registered onto the home location register of that particular area. I'll tell you everything now after this, finishing this slide. The location portability is also there. It means the portability that provides the flexibility to the user when it's shifting from one geographical location to another. Okay, so suppose from one region you are shifting to another region. So if you want to one state to another, also you can use it. And also the service portability is the provides the flexibility from 2G to 4G SIM card. You can observe that in many cases you will find that your SIM card was 2G, and when your device you are using is a 4G device, it's asking for that this is not a 4G enabled SIM. So you purchase a 4G enabled SIM with the same number, and you go on using that same SIM card now with the same number but with a 4G speed. So that is basically the service portability. So all these features needs to be provided by the networking part. Okay, the network, suppose it's an Airtel or a Jio or any operator for that matter, this is a mandatory thing that they need to provide. But before going to that process, as I told you that how the process involved, let me just go back and show you the basic requirements for a mobile portability. So you can observe here that we have usually the system will be something like this. Okay, so we have some kind of a base station placed over here. Okay, so suppose this is my base station A, if I call it, and we have a user who is hooked onto over here. Now what will happen, suppose this particular user is asking for a portable number, or he wants to port from one network to another. So there will be this particular number and the device will be hooked onto something called as HLR, or home location register. Again, the details of it will be discussed later. Just for the time being, we'll understand this way, that every user is connected to, or his registration is registered under a particular database, and that is called as HLR. Now this particular user is asking for a portable number. So what will happen? The base station is connected via something called as GMSC. Okay, so this request will go through something called as gateway MSC. This is called the writing will be there in the presentation. So gateway MSC, what does it do? The gateway MSC will be a port through which a device or a network A will connect to another network, which is B. Okay, so this is network B. So this gateway is the gateway through which this A and B will connect to themselves. Okay, just for the time being, we'll understand this way. Now what will happen? So this is the first instruction which will come, that I need to get this portability done. Now you are submitting all the documents in that way. That is an offline thing that you are doing with respect to this network. Internally, this is happening. That's the process involved. Now, when it comes as a request, the GMSC will send something as to signaling relay. This is a signaling relay. We call it signaling relay. That I need a MSRN, or we call it the mobile. We call it the, here you can see here it, I have mentioned already. So the first thing is originating network sends a request to the donor network. So here the donor network is this one. This is my donor network. Okay, this is my donor network. So it is where it is first hooked onto. Okay, now gateway MSC forwards the request to the recipient network via a signaling relay. So this is what I'm trying to drawing over here. So this is my
GMSC is the gateway mobile switching center, right?
Gateway mobile switching center, yes. Here I have mentioned gateway MSC. MSC stands for mobile switching center. Okay, yeah. Because I am not describing the overall architecture, that's why I'm skipping this part for the time being. So this is my donor network, this is the recipient network. That is where it will get the portable number to. So what we'll have is that this particular recipient will have another HLR over here, which is HLR B, and this is connected to the signaling protocol. Okay, so the signaling relay, so one, I will say two, the three signaling relay will send it to HLR will verify this with the recipient network, that all the offline documents, whatever is being sent from donor network to the recipient networks, are valid, that is the authentications are correct. If it is correct, then what will eventually happen, that the recipient network will send the request to HLR that provide a number, this mobile switching number. You can see this is MSRN, this is a temporary number, mobile station routing number, we call it MSRN. Okay, MSRN I have written here, MSRN. This is mobile station routing number. Okay, now this number comes to signaling relay for this particular user. Relay sends it to GMSC. GMSC sends it to the donor network to indicate that this particular user is now being ported. So what will happen, this particular donor network will have a database. Okay, this will have a database for all the portable customers. So portable customers. So what we will do, this MSRN or the new portable number will be stored for this particular user in this particular database of the donor network. Similarly, there will be another database over here of the recipient where the same user MSRN will be stored as a portable number. So what will happen, that whenever in the next phase, when the registration is okay, the portability is done, authentication is fine. So what will happen, that this user, whenever he tries to call someone, the donor network, because it is still the nearest network, because it will still have the same number, right? So the same number, it will, the donor network will identify this number that it is under the portability issue. So it will redirect directly without even concerning anything. It will redirect to this recipient network, and the recipient network will take care of the whole overall process of allotting a channel for that particular user and to go ahead with the calling. So the billing process and every other feature will be taken care of by the recipient network, and everything will be stored in this database of the recipient network. So initially there will be this handover process that will take place, but eventually this will go on in the same manner. So this is what about the, this is what the mobile portability is, what we are discussing over here. You can see this detail is over here. So I guess you have understood how the mobile portability works. So